Hey guys, Ride Sanger of Cardiff Security. Welcome back to the channel and welcome to another episode of Raj's Garage. This episode is going to be a little bit different to my previous episodes. We're currently over at Porsche Reading and we're here to spec my 992 GT3. I've already been here a month ago. I've got my build slot on the 992 GT3. I've paid my deposit. I've actually spec'd a car, but it's not the final spec version. I'm here in my 991.2 GT3. Porsche are going to give me an appraisal on this car. If you've not seen the video on this car, there's a link on the screen now and there'll be a link in the description. Watch that and I'll go through the whole story of this car and what's led me into the 992 GT3. Now, as I said earlier, this video is going to be a little bit different to our previous episodes of Raj's Garage where I go for a drive and I talk about a car. Today is going to be all about speccing the car, going through the Porsche configurator, which is absolutely fantastic to use. Colors, because color is important. Very subjective, very personal. It'd be nice to get your input on the colors as well, and we'll talk about that shortly. And we'll go through all the specifications list because it's just amazing the amount of toys you can throw on a brand new Porsche. So, here's my build slot and my deposit receipt. Let's get into the showroom and let's get Tina and Richie on the channel and we'll go through the whole process. Come on, follow me. Wow, cool showroom.
How are you?
I'm very good. Here is
good.
Tina.
Hello.
How are you?
Really good, thank you.
And there's
really
Richie
good.
Hiding. Hey Richie, how are we doing? Yeah, he's the reason why I'm into Porsches, okay, so blame him. So we're here to spec the GT3.
Perfect. Do you want to go into the office? Absolutely.
Let's go for it. Right guys, so as I said earlier, this is a little bit different to normal Raj's Garage videos. We're going to spec my 992 GT3. Colors are very important. I think color is something we'll start with first, Tina.
Absolutely.
So let's go through the configurator and show the color palette, so to speak.
Have you thought about color at all yet? Do you want to make something bright?
Or? I have a color in mind. Okay. And weirdest thing is my original spec, I've changed the color.
As always.
So okay. I've had 3 or 4 weeks to think about it. And even up until last night, I was a little bit unsure. Went to work this morning and the guys at work are like, no, you need to go for this color. You need to go. So okay. I'm not going to mention that color.
Okay.
But we'll go through the color options and the cost
like?
Options. Yeah.
Brilliant. So you've got your standard colors, black and white, and then we've got Guards Red and Racing Yellow. Bright seem to be the thing at the moment as well.
These are your flat colours, yeah, Richie?
That's right.
Yeah. Non-metallic?
Non-cost option, non-metallic.
Okay.
Flat colours, that's right.
And we've got our metallic colours for the classic Carrara White, Jet Black, which is really popular, Agate Grey, Dolomite Silver, which is slightly blue.
That's the...
I like that one.
That's the GT3 Touring outside.
That's it, yeah. So we've got our press car, GT3 Touring, that's in Dolomite, so it's got like a nice blue kind of
hue to it, yeah.
GT Silver, which you know well.
Yeah, same as mine. I think I need to move on from that.
Okay, and then we've got the Argentine Blue, which came out with the 992.
Okay.
Of course, special colours, crayon, very classic colour.
Well, crayon we know about because obviously you helped me spec my...
Absolutely, your KN
Coupe. Yeah, turbo, and that's in crayon.
That's right, and then we've got our brighter colours, Lava Orange. Now, Shark Blue's been really, really popular. It was launched in Shark Blue. You'll see a lot of those on the road. And Python Green, which was the latest edition.
Now, the Python Green, that's sort of more of a RS colour, is it not?
It's a classic colour.
Okay.
So you saw Viper Green was on 997 GT3 RS. Was one of the optional colours. But for me, anything wearing a GT badge, it's one of those iconic colours. It's almost got the Viper signal green kind of hue to it as well.
Okay.
For me, that's the colour.
So these cost options, the special colours, they are how much more?
£2,525. but well worth it.
Okay, so for starters, what's the base price on the car?
So we're starting off with a price of 100, and actually take the colour off. Standard colour, 131,530.
Okay. It's a tidy sum of money, that is. Okay, so I'll let you choose a colour.
Okay, I think we'll go for the green.
Okay, we'll go for the green.
Good choice.
Okay, that's not necessarily the colour I'm choosing. This is what Tina would choose, okay?
Fab. I think you've got to go bright. That's the season thing at the moment, is a nice bright colour.
Well, while we're on this screen configurator, shall we throw up the crayon?
Yeah.
The lava orange and the shark blue, the four colours.
Okay. So, classic colour.
I do love the crayon.
It is a bit of a firm favourite, especially on a GT customer as well. Okay. It does tend to be the colour of choice. So, nothing too bright, but it does stand out.
Okay.
You can see why it's a premium colour. The shark blue.
Most popular?
Yeah, it is popular. Been communication colour, so like Tina said, it's the colour it was launched in, so.
Right. And then we have lava orange, which again is more of an RS colour, no? Bit leery in your face?
Yeah, we had Gen 1 991 GT3 RS again. It was either ultraviolet, which was the solid purple colour, or lava, but like the two colours that they brought out, especially for that car, so. Again, if history kind of repeats itself, they would become firm favourites because they've always been iconic colours. But you see them on base Carrera, doesn't always be necessarily be a GT model, but they'll always be firm favourites because that's what become heritage, really, more than anything.
Okay, so shall we go back to crayon? Or did you choose? Oh, you chose green. You chose green.
Okay, we can sit with crayon.
No, we'll go with green. You chose green. Wheels. Although I've got black wheels on my current GT3, I'm not a fan of black wheels.
Black wheels seem to be a 991 thing, with 992, the silver wheel seems
I've seen
thing to do this season.
A lot of GT3s coming through, and silver wheels seem to be making a comeback.
Okay, let's go with silver. No cost option?
It's a no cost option, which is great. You can finish them, a satin neodyme. You've got the dark silver finish that you can put on the wheels if you'd prefer them to be a little bit darker.
And then you've got sort of a gold finish.
That's right. Again, very popular at the minute.
Okay, interesting. I think the gold works well on the black.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, absolutely.
Gold wheels on the black cars, that works really well. Brilliant. Okay, so...
And something that you can also now do, if we go to the side view, is that we can actually put a rim on it as well, if you prefer. You do have to choose a different colour wheel, so I don't know if that would make a difference to your selection, but you can actually line the outside of the wheel with red or blue, which also looks fab.
Well, let's go for the silver straightforward wheels.
Okay, I think that's a good choice. Brilliant. So, have you thought about seats? Because I know that you've got your full bucket seats in your current GT3.
For me, I have to have bucket seats. They're fantastic. I think they complement the car really well, work well with the Club Sport package. They look the part. I am not
That's what they look like.
A big guy, so I fit fairly well into a bucket seat. Okay, we'll go with the buckets. They look fantastic.
Fab. And have you thought about a contrast stitch at all?
Now, obviously, that would vary on the colour of the external car. So if you went for a guard's red, you'd probably have red stitching, I would have thought.
Red stitch. Or
if you went for the shark blue, you'd probably have blue stitching.
Yeah.
So I'll let you choose a colour.
Okay.
So this is stitching on the seat and on the dash?
It is, yeah, absolutely. So you can actually, I don't think it shows it very well on the configurator.
Okay.
But there are options that we can come back to later.
Okay.
Once we configure the interior.
Right,
You can choose to have the stitch. Okay. So, Club Sport package.
That's the cage.
That's
ultimately, that's the cage.
Yeah.
So we're going full on Club Sport.
Okay.
Not that I'll probably track the car much, but you know what? Might as well have the cage in there.
Absolutely. So the Club Sport package is a non-cost option.
Okay.
And if you want to, you can add the fire extinguisher, which is always a recommendation. It's only an extra £135, and if you do it now, it will cost you less than doing it in the
Is that
future.
The smaller fire extinguisher, or is that
It's 1 kilogram.
Okay, it's a smaller one.
Yeah.
We'll go with the fire extinguisher.
Brilliant. Okay. few lovely options in here. A lightweight carbon roof.
Right, I've got a list of options here, so we might as well spec it in your colour. The carbon roof is a must, I think. And on a colour outside of black, looks fantastic. With the black,
it does.
You just can't see the carbon roof.
You get that contrast, as you can see, from all angles.
Not cheap, though, is it?
It's not, but I think it makes a huge difference the way that it looks. And it definitely makes it stand out. With the club sport package as well, the carbon roof and those seats, it's that little bit of extra individualisation. But I think it's just a little bit of weight save as well, which is nice to have.
I quite like the little GT3 nod on the doors.
The little designation on the doors in black.
In black. There's an exclusive designed fuel filler cap.
Yep.
I know it's a lot of money, it's like £100, but it does look the part.
Yeah.
Okay. As you can see, you can actually change the colour of the stickers if you choose to, but I suppose it depends on your final colour choice, but black is quite classic.
So how much am I paying for these GT3 stickers on the side?
Okay. The stickers in black, £147.
That's crazy.
It's just one sticker.
Yeah.
It's one sticker. Two doors. Now, we spoke about this the other day. I am PPF in the car. Now, I know there's an option to have that film on the side of the rear arches.
Yeah.
So do I really need to option that sort of?
So the clear film standard, there is an option for black stone foils.
Okay, I don't want that.
But it depends if you want to break the color up, if you're going with like a two color scheme, black and let's say green, it just,
okay.
It's another accent really. So they both do exactly the same job, but you've got the choice of either clear or the black foil.
Okay, all right, we'll stick with the clear foil. So what else have I got here?
You get your black GT3 emblem on the rear there, as you can see. Yep. You can choose to delete that and then it just disappears, but I think it's nice.
Why would I delete the fact that I've got a GT3? Fan point stickers on the side. And you're giving me those stickers for free?
Absolutely.
Okay, yes. I'll keep those.
Those are already on the car, you do get that for free. And you can also choose to have the exterior mirror upper trims in carbon as well. That's £1,000 extra. The carbon's a pricey option, but it would match the roof if you decided to do that.
I have to go for that. I've already spec'd that, and when we move on to the inside, we'll talk carbon as well. So
brilliant.
That's externally done.
You can see how that looks just at the top of the ring mirror just there. Okay. Now, this is always a big argument. Do you go PDK or do you go manual?
I'm going PDK. For me, that works. I won't be using the car much on track. For those guys that want to track it, I think manual probably works for them. But even though the PDK changes gears so much quicker.
The PDK is quicker on track.
Yep.
Manual box, if you're more of out doing B-road runs, mountain runs, that sort of thing, it's more engaging on different. But for the quickest lap times, PDK.
I'm going PDK. Plus, I'll be using the car to and from work as well, stuck in traffic, I think. That would work really well. So we'll go 7-speed PDK, similar box to what I've got in the 991, I would have thought. Obviously the Chrono package, you know, it's
that's
a lot of
a
money. £336 for a little clock, but I think it's...
It's got your lap trigger in there, like, as well.
It's part of the whole 911 package as such.
Being a sports car.
Yes.
Through and through, you need the Chrono clock. Okay, so since you're not really going to be tracking it, would you like to go for the ceramic composite brakes?
I've got the ceramics on the 991 at the moment. Personally, I'd like to have the ceramics again, but I've been told there's a slight issue. Is there not with the ceramics?
There is, just as a temporary measure. So if you decided that you want to go for the option, it might mean that you'd wait a little bit longer for that particular option. It's something that would be made available later.
Okay.
However,
it's just a production delay, is it?
It is at the moment. Do you know much more about that?
Because it's just supply for demand, really.
Okay.
So at the moment, cars that have been fitted as standard, so like Turbo S models, that they still need to meet that demand for cars that have standard equipment fitted to them. Because there's been such a demand for them, they're having to either push allocations back slightly so they can fulfill customer wishes.
Okay.
But if the customer's happy having them still braking, and they can get their car in a fashion reasonable time. But it's just been, there's been a big demand for ceramic brakes, something probably they haven't seen before.
Okay.
But they're just trying to fulfill everyone's orders and what is a standard spec item as well.
Well, we'll leave the ceramics out for now.
Okay.
I've already had a chat with Richie off camera about potentially adding them on at a later date when they become available. So we'll leave them for now.
Okay. Axle lift.
100%.
Absolute must on a GT3.
Must. Speed amps, and my driver's on a slight incline, so that really helps.
Okay. Now, headlights.
Now, I'm going for the PDLS, it's called, is it?
Yeah, PDLS.
Which is very similar to what I've got on the 991.
That's right, yeah.
I love the lights, I love the setup and the look of the lights, and I think they're sort of a bit darker inside the frame of the light.
There's two different types. You've got PDLS Plus, and you have PDLS Plus.
Okay.
In black, like a tint finish.
Okay.
Which is more the inside of the housing's tinted, so it just gives it that more like a darker, aggressive sort of look.
Yeah. We'll go for that.
Brilliant. There is the option, depending on your exterior colour, to have an accent ring in the sharp blue, which just defines the light.
Mm.
So.
And how much are these lights?
So with the accent, it's at £812. The PDLS, £434. The matrix beam,
which is what I'd like to go for,
has been a problem with supply as well, due to semiconductor shortages. But I think we're okay with those lights at the moment.
Okay.
That's £2,500. But again, it's something that a GT3 or
everything's
a high-end 992.
Why can't it be in hundreds? Okay. Right. So we'll go with the PDLS.
Brilliant. And then let's look at the tail lights as well. So, exclusive design tail lights. The differentiated look. So you get the light arc without any red. Again, completely dependent, I think, on the exterior colour, whether or not you decide to go with that. And you get the illuminated lateral grills, and if I put those on the car and take them off, you can sort of see the difference they make.
Okay.
So you can see there that the red rear tail lights completely disappeared.
Do you have a
preference?
I prefer those. I think I've seen a car. Are there the lights in the night time which glow? Which are red all the way through.
The tail light, it's almost like it's like a complete light bar across the back.
Yeah, I've seen that, they look fantastic.
Standard is in red, but with the exclusive option is clear.
Okay, let's go with that. I don't need the privacy glass.
It's an aesthetic option.
Yeah, but we'll go with that.
We'll go for that. Now, privacy glass.
No, thank you. Okay, just a tick box exercise. I think we need a reversing camera. My garage is a little bit tight, and that will really help.
So moving on to the interior.
Okay, so I've got, again, a list of options here, so fire away.
Okay, so light design package. So it gives you ambient light around the console and the rear area, and you can change the colours of the interior. So you can set the mood. Again, if you want it to match your exterior, that's quite funky as well.
Okay, we'll go with that.
Really popular option, that one. Heated seats.
Which you can't have with the Club Sport.
You can't.
Okay, so we'll leave that one.
So, there's an extra option here with 3D printed body form, full bucket seats with a different degree of firmness. That is an expensive option.
No, I don't know. The standard buckets will do fine for me.
Fantastic. The storage package is a non-cost option.
Let's put
that in there. So, fire extinguisher, we've already spec'd that already. So we're really down to whether or not you want to color code your keys. And also looking at seat belts as well.
I'm not so fussed about the keys. Seat belt will be kind of cool. Obviously, it's varying on the external colour, so you've chosen green, so if you want to spec a seat belt colour, go for it.
Let's go for a green seat belt as well.
Okay.
You can just about see them there in the spec. Okay. And also your Sport Chrono stopwatch, would you want to colour code that as well?
I quite like the red, and I prefer the red rev counter. I think that works well as well.
It looks nice when everything's switched off, the car's shut down. There's just that, with the screens, it's just nice, that little band of colour.
Let's go with that. Yeah, that looks really nice. And then obviously the rev counter in red as well.
Sounds good. Okay. Smoking package we recommend just gives you that, it just changes that little compartment there.
Okay.
And it's only £38.
Okay. Well, I'm not a smoker, but we'll go for the smoking package. On the interior, I would prefer the carbon high gloss option, which is what I've got on the 991 GT3 currently. So if we can go with that. I know there's fair amount of leather that comes in the car. There's already some Alcantara in the car as well.
Price text, yep. Finish, yeah, in the car.
So if we can go for the extended or the carbon extended package, whatever it's called.
Okay, so you've got extended package in matte carbon, the carbon interior package high gloss.
I prefer the high
gloss. £926.
Yeah.
That gives you the trim strips in black, decorative inlays in carbon weave finish, and the dashboard, the door panel, and the centre console as well.
Okay, let's go with that.
Brilliant. You also get the door sill guards included. Great. Okay, so that brings us to audio. Bose, always a good idea.
We'll go with Bose. For £1,000, it's a lot easier just to go with the Bose. And it does sound pretty good, actually.
It actually does. Okay. Other than that, we're kind of down to more customizable options for you.
And also the leather sun visors?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Or you could have them in Racetex Alcantara, which would match some of the other accents in the car.
We'll probably go with the Alcantara, actually, which is what I've got.
In with, yeah, the door cards.
Okay.
It's just, I can't remember the headlining in those, I think, is Racetex.
Sun visors and Racetex?
Yes.
Okay.
I notice on the steering wheel now you've got volume controls and...
Yeah, it's a multi-function wheel, comes as...
Okay, standard now.
Yeah.
Okay. So okay, from the outside?
I think we're done. But that's not my colour choice, okay? That's Tina's colour choice, so I'm not necessarily going for green. I may go for green, but I'm not necessarily going for green. Now, where are we at in terms of cost?
So your spec, 151,585 plus your on-the-road costs.
Okay. And that's without the ceramics, because they're not available.
Absolutely right, yep.
Right, guys, I think we are there. Now, I've got to say, this Porsche configurator is probably one of the best configurators you can get for any brand. I'm not just saying that because I'm sitting here in Porsche. I've actually been playing around with this configurator quite a lot recently, and I've played with it on the 991 when the 991 came out. So I'm very familiar with the configurator. It's really easy to use. There'll be a link below in the description to the Porsche configurator. Why don't you go and configure your own GT3? I'm not guaranteeing you'll get a build slot, but Tina's details will be in the description below. By all means, you can drop her an email. So yeah, that doesn't mean you're gonna get a build slot, but you know what, play around with the configurator, choose your color. What color would you go for? I'm not revealing what color I'm going for, so I'm gonna hold on to that until the car is delivered. I've been told delivery could be as early as July, but there may be a delay purely because of wiring loom delays and so on and so on. But you know, so be it, I'm happy to wait a month or two more. We'll go over to the color options over there and we'll show you some of the color options. Voila. Okay. Let's quickly look at some of the exterior colors. So that's lizard green,
yep.
Racing yellow, which is different to my speed yellow.
Yeah. We got dolomite, which is the color,
okay,
we looked
at earlier.
Okay, that's
the color that's outside. Correct?
That looks like Carrara white.
Okay.
Carrara white.
Okay.
Yeah, it's chrome.
Okay, so that's crayon, which I have seriously considered, same as my Cayenne coupe.
Python.
So that's what we've just spec'd.
That's the one we were spec'ing.
That's what we've just spec'd.
Yeah.
Would you go green? Or would you go a different color?
Gentian blue that we spoke about.
It's a very deep blue.
Yeah. It's almost like a kind of like a midnight blue. Yeah. It's the most difficult thing. Guards red. Classic sports car colour, but yeah. For me, this is the most difficult choice, and it's the same when we're speccing the press cars. We want bright colours that stand out in magazines and film, that kind of thing, but also not every model you want in a bright colour. It's got to suit.
Got to suit the car.
Exactly, yeah.
And obviously, you've got all your options there for interior and so on. We won't necessarily go too much into that.
Yeah.
I think we're going to get an opportunity to walk around and have a look at some of the cars you've got on site.
Different colours.
Press cars. Which we're allowed to film. So let's show you some of them and then we'll go from there.
Right. Come on then, let's head round.
Conan, let's do it. Right, guys, we have racing yellow,
that's right,
and
python green, which is the color we put on the configurator, and it's on a 992, so you get all the angles and you get the visualization as well.
I actually love the Turbo S. It does look really bold in that yellow.
Yeah, it's got the aero kit on there as well.
Sure.
So there's a sport design package, and again this one as well, so GTS with the,
that does look very nice.
So it's quite, it's a rich green. It's not too washed out. It's quite right. You see I'm pushing the green here, aren't you?
He is, yeah.
But although it's your choice.
You can see why he would spec his colour option as. Okay, what else we got?
See if we can find an orange sharp blue. So this was the colour that the car was launched on. So
very common colour. It's the most popular.
Yeah.
It's the one I've seen the most of.
It is popular. It does hark back to Mexico blues, Riviera blues, and this is again Porsche have listened to what people want.
Sure.
And so they brought out a new colour.
Is this the PDLS?
It is,
the lighting system?
So this is the headlights that we spec as well.
Yep.
PDLS Plus with the black accents.
I love those.
Crayon? Yeah.
Okay, not a GT3, guys. A GTS?
It is a 4S.
4S, okay.
With the sport design package. So it has the rear spoiler and it's got like the almost like a deeper front bumper as well with a different
air intake. Okay, so this has got glass roof, like a panel roof.
Yeah.
But you can imagine if that was carbon, that'd be in black. So that'll give you the contrast between having the crayon paint and the black sort of carbon roof.
That's it.
It does look nice. This is on my list of colours. You know, probably three colours that I've got. This is on there. So I'm not sure. I'm not sure yet. Right, guys, we're going to end the episode here. I'm going to carry on looking at colours here in this, you know, Porsche matchbox car park, you know, kid in the candy shop, so to speak. Richie, thank you very much.
Hey, you're welcome.
Obviously,
anytime.
thank you to Tina, and thank you to David, who does not want to come on the camera, but thank you to David as well for helping me get my allocation of the 992 GT3. Still can't believe it, guys. I've actually got allocation of the 992 GT3. A dream come true. Now, what color should I go for? Get on the configurator, play around with it. What color would you go for? Throw it in the comments, you know, be as leery as you want, be as bold as you want, or be as calm as you want. Totally up to you. Let's try and crash the Porsche site. Everyone get on that configurator now and just configure your cars. If it does crash, don't blame me. Guys, obviously comment down below. Most importantly, like this video. I will be back at some point, back again at Porsche Reading, and we'll talk about the 992, maybe before the car gets delivered. If not, when the car does get delivered, we'll reveal the color to you and we'll do a presentation on the car. But until then, like, share and subscribe, and I'll be back on the channel very soon.